Next thing we've got to do is rebuild ALSA plugins. So I didn't keep that up, unfortunately. So let's get that up there. And just rebuild this. And reinstall it. And this is because of a dependency on FFmpeg. Possibly also libsample, right? I can't remember now. I forgot to mention that libass, which we built a few packages ago, is also a requirement for MythTV. So that's ALSA. We've now got MariaDB to do, and libevent is a recommended package, so we'll do that next. Set command here. There's no other options mentioned in the config explanation, so I'll just copy and paste that. And we can check the results. It does say that 6 tests in every suite related to regress SSL fail. Right, so we did get these tests that failed. So six in each suite, I guess that is. So that makes sense. So we can just do make install. And that's it, we're not going to install any more documentation. So now I can install MariaDB. So this is quite critical to the working of MythTV. As I said, it's what everything about recordings and schedules and things, the channels that are found, all their frequencies and so on, everything, the names, the call signs, the channel numbers, you name it, it all gets stored in a MariaDB or MySQL database. It says the installed size of MariaDB is 658, but it can be reduced by about 252 if desired by removing. Really, I would say that this should be put down to the bottom after you've done the install, because I always forget to delete this. Maybe have a note about it and then have another note saying like this can be deleted now. Seems a bit sort of daft having it at this point here. Yes, MariaDB and MySQL, although they're basically compatible, you can't have both on the same system without some seriously nifty reconfiguration. And MariaDB is the preferred open source version. So we've got to create a user for MariaDB and a group. So let's do that now. And then extract MariaDB. Make a temporary directory. Got this massive configuration. Let's double check what the command installations are. Embedded server is on. Extra char sets equals complex. Skip tests on. Okay, so that's for tests which haven't got support. And user switch, we don't want the server, we'd like to build the client only. We don't want the client only, we definitely do want the server. So let's just make sure we haven't got that. Probably not. Yep, I can't see it. So the default configuration is fine for our setup. Okay, so that's done. Let's now build it. Okay, we've got the build complete there. So just time make test to run the tests. Okay, one test connect is known to fail, and we've got that. It says a more extensive set of tests can be run with the following. It does take quite a while, 24 SPUs. Now, I'm going to run this because, as I said, MySQL is quite critical to the functioning of MythTV. So let's get this started. Parallel N 4, and we'll wait for those tests to complete. Okay, so that's finished. It says a few tests may fail. We had 3 tests out of nearly 6,000, so that's 0.05%, which I think is a pretty good result. 2 of them are to do with character sets. That one could well be to do with character sets as well. In var log, is that in this directory or on the system var log? Looks like it's in the system var log. Let's have a quick look to see if we can make any sense of that. Oh no, I can't imagine it'd be there actually. Let's see if it's under testing tests. No, I'm not sure where that is. Could be in the parent directory. No, there's no var log there either, so I'm not really sure where they are. No, I haven't got a clue. Let's try looking for star.log. Okay, could be that file there. Test connect, so that's the short test. Is there anything obvious here? No, the only thing that's been updated there recently at 7:26, it's now 17:32, is the mail.log. So it's nothing there at all. No, I'm a bit stuck by what that is. All right, I didn't do pop D, never mind. CD MySQL. No, BLFS. MySQL. No, MariaDB. That's it, we'll get there in the end. Okay, so let's do the install now. Oh, we're in the build. Right, so let's become root. And put this configuration file in. Now this was the cause of the problem that I had getting MythTV working. This option here stops MythTV from communicating with MySQL because it does it over a TCP/IP port, and I presume it's because you can have the back end on a different machine, so it just defaults to working on the local machine if you've got the back end and front end on the same machine. So what I'm going to do now, before doing anything else, is to edit this file and comment that out, because I'll probably forget. And I'll check that it's been written correctly, this file. Yes, it has. So comment that out, and hopefully I won't have the problems that I had trying to get this to work. So you can now install a database and change the ownership to the unprivileged user and group, perform as the root user. So we'll run those commands. Okay, so further configuration requires that the MariaDB server is running. Start the server using the following commands as a root user. So that should be running in the background. Now we set a password for the administrator. So although the administrator is called root, this has nothing to do with the root user of the Linux system. This is the DBA, the database admin's password. So set that to something and remember it. Configuration of the server is now finished. Shut down the server using the following command as the root user. Oops, just the once. Type in the DBA password, and that's the server stopped. So now we're going to BLFS boot scripts to install the startup scripts, and we can now restart the SQL server using those scripts. So that should be running now. Right, now I had this before, this led me up the garden path. I keep saying it's not running, but it is actually running, because if you grep for MySQL, is it? There's the daemon running, so it's definitely running. There must be something wrong with that script, that it's not detecting the fact that the daemon is running. Maybe because this daemon, this file name, or yeah, the script name is not the same name as the executable is looking for, possibly, I don't know. But it is definitely running. We'll see that later on when we come to create the database for MythTV. So that was MariaDB. Now we can now remove the test. Where is it? Yeah, the test directory after installation. So let's do that now. Let's see how big it is, actually. 252 meg, so yeah, that's quite a chunk. Okay. So that's MariaDB completed. And I'll close that down and tidy this up.